Good morning all of you. How are you all? Hope all of you are fine. Let's start today's class. We are going to start our unit number 2, The World of Trees. And the section 1, Redwoods, the Super Trees. Please be ready with your textbook, notebook, okay, and a pen. Listen here, all of you. Take the page number 31. The world of trees. Here is a quoting. What we are doing to the forest of the world is but a reflection of what we are doing to ourselves and to one another. It's a quote by our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Here is a warm-up activity for you. Just do it now. Can you identify the leaves given below? Match the leaves to the trees or plants they belong to. One has been done for you. Okay, very easy. Do it fast. Then just turn your page into page number 32, section 1, Redwoods, the Super Trees. Do you know the redwood trees? Anyone know? Sometimes you may have seen the photo of redwoods. Okay, now you could see the redwoods photo in the screen. Are trees able to protect themselves? Is it possible to get wood from forests without harming the environment in the long run? Let's read and find out. This chapter is adapted from Redwoods, the Super Trees by Joel Bond in National Geographic magazine, October 2009. Joel Bond, he lives in California and he is a contributing writer for National Geographic, okay, and he is an award winning journalist who has covered national and international environmental issues for the past 20 years. Okay, let's start our class. Are trees able to protect themselves? Do you think trees are able to protect themselves? Yes or no? No. Listen, just to start our class. Some of the largest and tallest trees of the world are redwood trees. They can live to be thousands of years old. They can provide timber, support jobs, safeguard clear water, and provide refuge for countless forest species. Long ago, these trees were found worldwide, but now they are found only in certain parts of the world. One belt of redwood forest is found in California, USA. Listen here. Redwood trees, the largest trees in the world. It can grow up to a 94.8 meter, 70 meter across also. It is most common in the coastal forest of Northern California. And also it has a capacity to resist fire because of its thick bark. Okay. Then it is most common in California. Listen here. Some of the largest and tallest trees of the world are redwood trees. Redwood trees are some of the largest and the tallest trees in the world. They can live to be thousands of years old. The lifespan of the redwood trees are almost thousands of years old. Can you imagine such a tree? Just look at the picture, how redwood trees look like. They can provide timber. Timber, you know, that we are using to make building, the pieces of wood we are using to make building or making things, and support jobs. In forest also, many are the working. Okay, some officers are there, guards are there, and loggers are there. Okay, many jobs also, support jobs. Safeguard clear water, giving protection or protection for the water, and to provide refuge for countless forest species. These redwoods are providing shelter or protection for the more living species, that means more living organisms. Okay. Long ago these trees were found worldwide, but now they are found only in certain parts of the world. Before that, everywhere, almost in the world, we could see the redwoods. but now it is almost seeing only in the certain parts of the world. One belt of redwood forest is found in California, USA. Among that, one place is California in USA. Listen. Second paragraph. Mike Fay, a biologist, wanted to determine if there was a way for humans to live in harmony with the forest. That is, to maximize both timber production and the many benefits forests provide. He believed that if it could be done in the redwoods, it could be done anywhere on the planet where forests are being flattened for short-term gain. So, he and his hiking partner Lindsay Holm took an 11-month trek through the magical redwood forest of California. The team talked to the people of the redwoods as well. Loggers, foresters, biologists, environmentalists, are cafe owners and timber company executives, all of whom are dependent on the forest for a livelihood. They took pictures and detailed notes to record wildlife, plant life and the condition of the forest and stream. Okay, just to come back to our second paragraph, Mike Fay, a biologist, wanted to determine if there was a way for humans to live in harmony with the forest. Mike Fay wanted to find out, is it possible to live human beings in a harmonious relation with the forest? Is it possible without making any harm to the forest? Okay. That is, to maximize both the timber production and the many benefits forests provide. They have to maximize the production of timber, and also we are getting many benefits through this forest, okay, that is given in the next sentences. He believed that if it could be done in the redwoods, if it is possible in the redwoods, it could be done anywhere on the planet. Okay, if it is possible in the redwood, it will be possible anywhere in the planet where forests are being flattened, where forests are being, the trees are being cut down, okay, for short-term gain. We are cutting the trees for a short-term gain. Okay, if we could maximize the timber production, that will be helpful for us. Listen, so he and his hiking partner, hiking partner means a person who is walking with someone for a pleasure or for a trip. Okay. Hiking partner Lindsay Holm took an 11-month trek through the magical redwood forest of California. This Mike Fay and his partner Lindsay Holm, they both of them conducted a trekking through the magical redwoods, through the forest. Okay, through the redwood forest for, you know, for 11 months. Then the team talked to the people of the redwoods as well. To understand more about the redwood trees, the team talked to, you know, to loggers. Loggers means those who are cutting down the trees. Foresters, they are foresters means those who are dealing with the forest, those who are managing. Then biologists, environmentalists, cafe owners, and timber company executives. All they have discussed to understand more about the redwoods, okay? All of whom are dependent on the forest for a livelihood. These persons are depending the forest for a livelihood, for they have to earn money so they could live. They took pictures and detailed notes to record wildlife, plant life and the condition of the forest and the stream. They have taken some photos and asked some notes, everything is to understand wildlife and plant life and the condition of the forest and also stream. Hope, can you understand? Yes, listen. To the third paragraph. On a glorious May day, nearly 3/4 of the way into their project, they arrived at the southern end of Humboldt Redwood State Park, home to the largest contiguous block of old-growth redwood forest left on the planet. They entered the translucent shade of the most magnificent grove they had seen yet. They were awed by the beauty around them. Let's listen. On a glorious May day, nearly 3/4 of the way into their project, They arrived at the southern end of Humboldt Redwood State Park. Both of them, Mike Fay and his partner Lindsey Holm, both of them arrived at the Humboldt Redwood State Park, home to the largest contiguous block of old growth redwood forest left on the planet. One new word is the first word was the timber. Another one, contiguous. Contiguous means that it is sharing a border. Listen, Humboldt Redwood State Park is situated in a border. That means it is sharing a border. And block of old growth redwood forest left on the planet. In that Humboldt Redwood State Park, there is the old growth, the oldest redwood trees are left in the planet. Okay. There is the oldest redwood trees. They endured the translucent shade of the most magnificent grove they had seen yet. Just imagine in your mind, you are entering to a forest, then from somewhere you could see the ray of light is coming into the forest. Okay, translucent is the another word. Okay. Translucent, the meaning is given here, allowing light to pass through, because they are explaining the beauty of the forest. It is full of redwood trees, and among that the ray of light is coming to the forest. Entered the translucent shade of most magnificent grove they had seen it. Up to this time they didn't see such a beautiful forest. That means magnificent grove means, magnificent means something attractive. Grove means small trees. Okay, they had seen it. They were awed by the beauty around them. Both of them were in a wondered situation or an excitement, because such a beauty was that forest. Forest means that Humboldt Redwood State Park. Listen, then the last paragraph. Redwoods sprouted from the ground like giant beanstalks, their buds blackened by the forest fires. Some of them had huge cavities big enough to hold 20 people. All of it brought to their minds the Jurassic Park series. Some of the scenes were actually filmed here. And they felt a T-Rex would pop its head out from behind a tree at any minute. Listen. Redwoods sprouted from a ground like giant beanstalk. You know the meaning of the word sprouted. Sprout means a shoot of plant is coming out. Redwoods sprouted from the ground like giant beanstalk. Beanstalk means the stem of bean. Okay, the redwood is sprouting like a beanstalk is sprouting. Okay, beanstalk is coming. Their buds blackened by forest fires. Buds meaning is given here, the larger, thicker ends of trees. Buds. Buds. Just note down these words to your notebook. And blackened by forest fires. Some of them had huge cavities big enough to hold 20 people. Can you imagine such a tree? It may have a cavity of including almost 20 people. Okay, just imagine the redwood. All of it brought to their minds the Jurassic Park series. After seeing this, both of them felt they are seeing some Jurassic Park series. And some of the scenes were actually filmed also here, okay? And they felt a T-Rex, T-Rex means a large carnivore, as it's looked like a dinosaur, and it could walk on two legs. Okay, that you could see in the screen. T-Rex would poke its head out from behind a tree at any minute. They are thinking that sometimes any T-Rex will come to them to poke them. pain for us, okay? Its head out from behind a tree at any minute. The team learned that there are several factors that make these trees hardy. One is that they contain compounds called polyphenols, which keep bugs and decay-causing fungi away. This makes these trees highly rot-resistant. Another factor is that they do not have a lot of resin in their bark. So larger redwoods are highly resistant to fire too. Because of these two factors, these trees are naturally equipped to fight the two major threats faced by most other trees, rot and wildfire. Listen to the page number 33. The team learned that there are several factors that make these trees hardy. They have asked to the loggers, the foresters, the biologists, environmentalists. After that, they got some ideas about redwood trees that they are saying here. The team learned that there are, you know, which team? The team by our Mike Fay and Lindsay Holm. Okay. The team learned that there are several factors that factors are making these redwoods as a hard one. One is that they contain compounds called polyphenols, which keep bugs and decay causing fungi away. Another word is here, compound. Compound, listen, a substance formed by a chemical reaction of two or more elements. Compounds called, which compound is here? Polyphenols. Polyphenols is a micronutrient, okay? Which could keep the bugs, you know, the bugs and decay causing fungi away. The compound and the substance polyphenol, it is helpful to keep the bugs and decay causing fungi also away, so the redwood trees can grow without any hindrances, okay? Next line. This make these trees highly rot resistant. Rot resistant means it prevent from decaying, okay? Decay resistant. Another factor is that they do not have lot of resin. Resin means a solid substance like a sticky one, like a plant's trees gum, you know, such one, sticky one, okay? Sticky solid substance, resin. Meaning is given in your book. A sticky substance produced by some trees. Resin in their bark. So larger redwoods are highly resistant to fire too. And also one more speciality is the according to the lifespan or the growth of the redwood trees, it could resist the fire too. Because of these two factors, these trees are naturally equipped to fight the two major threats faced by most other trees, rot and wildfire. Most of the trees are, they have the threatened that some fungi or bugs or any other problems will be there. But in this compound of polyphenol help this redwood to protect from decaying, and also its bark are very thick. Bark, you know, the outer layer of the tree, that also protecting the tree from wildfire, okay? Then the next paragraph. Perhaps the most amazing thing about redwoods is their ability to produce sprout whenever the living tissue just beneath the bark is exposed to light. If the top break off or a limb gets cut, a new branch will sprout from the wound and grow quickly. Throughout the forest, you can find stems with a cluster of second generation trees around their bases. Listen to this paragraph. Perhaps sometimes the most amazing thing about redwood is their ability to produce, you know, sprouts. Ability to produce that small plant of shoot. Whenever the living tissue just beneath the bark is exposed to light, this sprout only near the exposure to the light, then from there, from the ground itself, from the redwood itself, it will start to grow. It's only need, you know, the sunlight for the photosynthesis. Exposed to light. If the top breaks off or a limb gets cut, or if any branch is cut down or the toe breaks, it's also no problem. A new branch will sprout from the wound and grow quickly. If the redwoods we are cutting from here or it's broken, its branch is broken, no problem. From here onwards another sprout will come out, okay? The tree will start to grow. A new branch will sprout from the wound and grow quickly. Okay? Throughout the forest you can find stems with a cluster of second generation around their bases. You know what you mean by stem? You know, all of you may know the cricket stem. No, stem. Stem. Listen. Whenever we are cutting a tree, if just imagine this is a tree, I am cutting the tree from here, okay, then what will happen? Up to this part is the stem, okay, including that root part, okay. Stem means the meaning is given here, the bottom part of a tree left in the ground after the rest has been cut down. After that cutting down, the rest of the tree with a cluster of second generation. Listen, from I have cut this tree from here, okay, I don't know actually how to draw, then this one is calling the stem, but from here itself this one is calling the stem, from here itself the redwood has the capacity to make it second generation, means from here itself it could grow, okay. Then with a cluster of second generation trees, second generation trees meaning is given here, trees that come up naturally after removal of the first growth by cutting or by fire around their bases. Listen, next one. Sometimes when a living tree is knocked over, it tries to continue growing, the limbs pointing up will turn into trees in time. Listen, you know what happens sometimes when a living tree is knocked over, means to strike to the ground, okay. If it is a redwood tree, knocked over means just push it, okay, not by cutting, okay, then knocked over to strike to the ground, okay, it is fell down to the ground, it tries to continue growing, from there itself it will start to continue its growing. The limbs pointing up will turn into tree in time. Next one. Can you follow me? Now you have got an image about redwood trees, about its lifespan, about its physical features and how that much lifespan. What is the reason? The first one is the component of polyphenol. It will keep the bugs and other decaying substance away, okay. Then and also it could protect from wildfire also, okay. Then the another paragraph, most of the trees produce seeds that help them to produce new plants, but the redwood cones are tiny and produce seeds infrequently, so stem sprouting has been a key to the survival of the redwoods. Listen, most of the trees, you know how the seed is germinating, all of you know. Then here in this situation, you know, most of the trees produce seeds that help them to produce new plants. You know, next generation is coming through, some of the plants it is with the help of seeds. But the redwood cones that you could see here, but the redwood cones are tiny and produce seeds infrequently. That's not producing the seeds frequently. So actually there is no chance for the this much number of redwood trees, okay. How is it possible, you know? So stem sprouting has been the key to the survival of the redwoods. Actually the stem sprouting is the only way for the survival of the redwoods, because of the capacity of stem sprouting. Wherever I have told you, wherever we are cutting the tree, from there itself it will start its growth again, okay. So because of that capacity only the redwoods are surviving. The last paragraph, Stephen G. Sillett, an expert on redwoods, told the team that a tree's annual rate of food wood production increases with age for at least 1500 years. Turn to the next page. More importantly, the older it gets, the more high quality rot resistant hardwood it puts on. Listen here, Stephen Sisslett, an expert on redwoods, he also may have experienced many things regarding these redwoods, told the team that a tree's annual rate of wood production increases. The annual rate of wood production increases when do you know? With age for at least 1500 years. At least maximum the lifespan of redwood is, we have studied 1000 years. More than that, how much lifespan is this redwood trees are getting, that much good for that timber also. More importantly, the older it gets, the more high quality rot resistant hardwood it puts on. Hardwood, you know, you could see here in your book. Okay, the hard older inner layer of the wood of a tree. Okay, last paragraph. In other words, redwoods produce more wood and better wood as they become older. This is said to be true for the tallest eucalyptus trees in Australia too, and it may be true for other trees around the world. This convinced Mike Fay that people, wildlife, and perhaps even the planet could benefit from a little care and a different kinds of forestry in which forests are not completely flattened. Listen here. In other words, redwoods produce more wood. Yes, redwoods are producing more wood, that we know. Okay. And better wood as they become older. How much it is old, that much will be the quality of the wood also. This is said to be true for the tallest eucalyptus trees in Australia too. This is same to eucalyptus tree also in Australia. And it may be true for other trees around the world. Yes, but we have a tendency by looking at the tree, we are deciding to cut it. But as much as possible, the tree could grow, that much the quality of the tree also will increase. This convinced Mike Fay that people, wildlife, and perhaps even the planet could benefit from a little care and a different kind of forestry in which forests are not completely flattened. If it is possible, means we could, forestry means a science of dealing with the forest, okay, practice or planting or managing and caring forest, okay. If we are giving the maximum lifespan to the trees without cutting it, we could save our forest and also not completely flattened. Don't cut it completely, okay. First I have taught. This is adapted from Redwoods, the Super Trees by Joel Bond in National Geographic Magazine, October 2009. Listen, you have to do one thing, read the textbook at least 4 times, okay. Then read every sentences carefully. Now down the difficult words from here. Other than these words, you may have difficult words. Every words I have told, but in between, if you have any doubts, okay, please check in a dictionary. If it is not getting, please contact me. If you have any doubts also, you can call me. Hope all of you have understood. Thank you. Have a nice day.